So tell me a little bit about your experience with your mentor through the Come to Work program.
Yeah, so I actually had Jennifer McNeil Noble, or Jen for short.
Yeah, I know.
She was, as I mentioned before, one of my absolutely idolized Come to Work instructors, and I was so thrilled to have her as a mentor. I did like a little cheer in my room when I got that notification. She was just so wonderfully welcoming and engaging, as well as encouraging and supportive. I knew right away in our first session that we had together, I was going to learn so much from her.
How long have you and Jen been meeting so far?
I think our first meeting was July, I believe. It all kind of blurs together.
I know, especially during the pandemic months. It just feels like one big clump.
But it does.
July to September, that's like a month and a half, 2 months around there.
Yeah.
What would you say are some of the key things that you would have learned from Jen?
So I actually told her I wanted to focus on my interview skills, as I felt this was kind of an area I was weak in. Mm-hmm. And it actually kind of lined up with the process that I was undertaking to get the job I'm currently in.
Nice.
So Jen kind of taught me how to navigate through the entire interview process from beginning to end, right from like accepting the interview to, as I mentioned, the follow-up. I honestly attribute a large part of my success at being hired in government to her unflinching confidence in me and the skills that she imparted.
Do you ever see yourself being a mentor to someone else down the road?
Oh, absolutely. I genuinely hope that later in my career I can turn the favor, especially if it involves mentoring a blind individual.
Tell me a bit about what it is like to work for the BC government.
It's only the end of my second week, but so far I'm loving it, I have to say.
Nice.
Everyone is professional, but so friendly. At least in my experience, the BC government has been exceptionally accommodating regarding providing assistive technology and whatnot. So my direct supervisor in particular is an absolutely lovely person who is wonderful to work with, and she kind of provides the perfect blend of support and instruction. I anticipate learning a lot, and I'm so looking forward to it.
What is the title of your position?
I love this. So my title is Stakeholder Engagement Support. I think all government titles tend to be a bit vague, but basically I'm an intern.
That's all good. What are some of your responsibilities? What does a typical day at work look like?
Right. Well, it's a lot of meetings for a typical day at work, for sure. There's a lot of check-ins with my supervisor, and then we'll have team meetings. Sometimes we'll have all staff calls. Those are more rare. I haven't been on one of those yet. I think they're only once a month. Mm-hmm. But basically, I'm going to be responsible for drafting briefing notes, presentations, reports, documents for both like internal and external audiences. So I might type up meeting agendas for internal, or I might type up, you know, an informational document for an external stakeholder that our team is interacting with. For example, one of my tasks this week was to create a type of FAQ sheet for a large organization my branch was working with. Mm-hmm. And this is actually to support the hiring of WorkBC clients, which I was so excited about and passionate about. And then another piece of my job is I'll also be building working relationships with large stakeholders and providing information and presentations related to diversity.
That sounds like an incredibly interesting job, if you don't mind me saying so.
It's so much fun.
Is it based out of Richmond, or do you have to try?
It's actually based out of Victoria, but because everything is virtual, I can work from home here in Richmond. I think there's one other member of our team who also works out of the Vancouver office, but three of them, I believe, are in Victoria. We're a relatively small team, so.
Nice, I know the feeling. Tell me a little bit about what it was like to go into your interview. You know, using the interview skills that you learned from your mentor, what was it like to sort of prep for that? And what was your attitude going in?
So going into the interview, I was very, very nervous. Kind of a lot rode on my success with this. And I had one difficult interview in the past a few years ago where I felt like I kind of did not do my best. So not only did I kind of really want to succeed and get a job, but I also wanted to kind of prove to myself that I had improved those skills. And I got the job, so I think I did.
You clearly got your answer. Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm.